The Duke of Sussex is just weeks away from becoming a father to his firstborn child with wife Meghan. And Prince Harry, 34, proved his paternal side as he greeted waiting crowds outside Future, the new youth zone in East London's Barking and Dagenham on Thursday. The expectant father was there to open the new youth facility, which aims to provide young people with more activities, and was seen playfully ruffling the hood of a waiting young fan. He shared a gallery of pictures to his 4.4 million followers on his official Instagram account shortly after the visit. Once inside, he greeted a delighted well-wisher, accepting what appeared to be a baby gift from the youngster before exploring the facilities. Dressed in a smart gray blazer and crisp white shirt, Harry cut a handsome figure as he spoke to employees at the new space. The purpose-built facility for the borough's young people has been created by the charity OnSign Youth Zones, which is developing 21st-century youth facilities across the UK. Future Youth Zone provides a safe environment where young people can come and enjoy themselves, build key skills and raise their aspirations and confidence to create a happier and healthier generation. It is the first of three on-site youth zones in London expected to open this year. Harry went on to share a gallery of images from his visits to the centre, which he previously visited with his wife Meghan Markle. He took on the visit today solo, but looked to be having a fantastic day taking part in a whole host of activities. The father-to-be posed for pictures with a group of teenagers taking part in the Box Up Crime Scheme, which is a youth organization aiming to get children out of gangs in the local area. On his arrival, he was greeted to a rockstar-like welcome, with hordes of screaming people excitedly taking photographs and waving union flags. During his visit, the Duke was pictured meeting young people who have been involved in the development of the new youth zone, as they took part in a number of activities and workshops showcasing the facilities, before unveiling a plaque to mark the visit. He was pictured enthusiastically taking part in ball games, as well as helping out with rock climbing and arts and crafts. Harry also joined members of Barking and Dagenham, BAD, Youth Forum and Youth Zone members as they shared their perspectives and experiences of knife crime, amidst a national rise in incidents, and discussed potential solutions. The forum has already worked with councillors and police to voice their concerns about youth crime and violence in the area. Barking and Dagenham Youth Zone, which was given its name by local young people, will be open 7 days a week for those aged 8 to 19, and up to 25 for those with additional needs. The Youth Zone will offer sports, music and arts activities as well as access to qualified youth workers offering support and advice on issues affecting the community the most, such as mental health and employability. BAD Youth Forum was created in 2001, to give young people a formal and recognized platform to express their views on issues affecting their lives and communities, and a way to make a positive impact on their community. Today the forum, comprising of 13 to 19-year-olds elected by peers in schools and youth groups, continues to have a say and influence on policy makers. Harry has previously highlighted his belief that every child should be given the opportunity to fulfill their potential, regardless of their background or situation. This will be third time that Harry has visited an on-site youth zone, having previously visited Wigan Youth Zone in July 2016 and the Hive Wirral Youth Zone in January 2019 with the Duchess. This visit also furthers the ongoing work the Duke of Sussex is doing with the Royal Foundation to explore the solutions to youth violence that young people themselves wish to see. His appearance follows the news that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will announce the birth of their baby once they have had an opportunity to celebrate privately as a new family. Kensington Palace announced today. Meghan is expected to have a midwife-led home birth at Frogmore Cottage in Windsor, the new home she shares with Prince Harry on the Berkshire estate. She will follow in the footsteps of the Queen, who was born at the Mayfair home of her grandparents and gave birth to all four of her children at either Buckingham Palace or Clarence House. A Kensington Palace spokesman said, "The Duke and Duchess of Sussex are very grateful for the goodwill they have received from people throughout the United Kingdom and around the world as they prepare to welcome their baby. Their Royal Highnesses have taken a personal decision to keep their plans around the arrival of their baby private. The Duke and Duchess look forward to sharing the exciting news with everyone once they have had an opportunity to celebrate privately as a new family.